Good morning, students. The next topic for discussion in strategic cost management and performance evaluation, paper 5 of CA final syllabus, is chapter number 4, which deals with cost management techniques. After having covered the first three chapters, let us move forward with this chapter. Now, under the cost management techniques, if one were to look at the study material, page number 2, to get a brief overview of the topic, it includes certain components like, for example, cost control, life cycle costing, cost reduction, target costing, value analysis and value engineering, and environmental management accounting. These are going to be the broad concepts, including Pareto analysis, that will be analyzed in this particular chapter. Now, obviously, from a strategic cost management perspective, we should be aware of what are the different techniques available to implement at a strategic level cost reduction. Now, with regard to cost control and cost reduction, these are two different concepts that have been dealt with at the intermediate level itself. Nevertheless, let us quickly go through these two concepts. The very first thing being cost control. Now, the fact that the phrase cost control is used indicates there is some kind of a control mechanism there. Whenever we refer to a control mechanism, obviously we understand that there must be something to be measured against. Otherwise, we can't control something. So there has to be some actual data which will have to be collected and compared against some predetermined data. The predetermined data might take the form of budgets or standards. The actual data will be post the event. The cost of a particular activity can be collated and compared against the budgets. And that's how we try to analyze the variances even in standard costing, trying to know whether it is a favorable variance or an unfavorable variance, and initiate corrective action if any required. So cost control typically is something which deals with essentially just restricting the cost component vis-a-vis the budgeted numbers that have been permitted to be expended. So when the budgets have been set, individually there might be some standards which are involved in setting the budgeting exercise itself. But then cost control is not interested in looking at that part of it. It is only an administrative process of trying to ensure that the costs incurred against each particular activity specified in the budget is kept within the budget limits. It does not go on to challenge why a particular standard has been set the way it has been set up. That's a significant point of differentiation between cost control and cost reduction. So in cost control, probably when a particular department tries to control cost, it might probably result even in a drop in the quality of the product itself, possibly. Whereas this would never be the case in a scenario of cost reduction. Cost reduction typically tends to be more permanent in nature, and it is something wherein the organization tries to achieve something which will be real in terms of a cost reduction, as well as something which will be long lasting. Now, therefore, if something has to be real and long-lasting, it also should not be one-time effort. Therefore, it automatically involves a continuous process of constantly paying attention to the cost factor to find out different ways of trying to reduce the cost. Now, one very key aspect to be borne in mind, while cost reduction refers to a real and permanent reduction in the unit cost, this cannot be achieved by compromising upon the quality of the output. The quality must either remain at the earlier level itself, or it could possibly improve. It should never deteriorate. That would never be covered under cost reduction. So cost reduction typically is not just concerned with trying to restrict the amount of cost within a budgeted amount. Irrespective of whether a budget exists or not, Logically, a person would look at the processes of manufacturing or any system and try to analyze and find out would there be a better way of doing things such that it results in a more effective and efficient process, thereby reducing the unit cost. So it challenges the standards or budgets if any exists. Now, therefore, to that extent, I would say cost reduction tends to be more dynamic in nature. Well, in our study material, there is a tabulated sheet given, a page wherein cost reduction and cost control has been differentiated. It's quite self-explanatory because cost reduction is permanent, whereas cost control would be temporary. And this is more permanent in nature, whereas control would be relatively temporary. Reduction involves a continuous process, whereas cost control would probably stop the moment you have reached a number which is below the budget. You're not much worried about it. Cost reduction would challenge the standards itself, which doesn't happen in the case of cost control. Cost reduction would be more dynamic than what would be the case of cost control. Okay. And cost reduction typically tends to be more futuristic, while cost control tends to be more of an analysis relating to the past events that have taken place. Now, moving on from there, with regard to the scope of cost reduction, there are certain aspects that we need to bear in mind. For example, product design. Well, in a manufacturing establishment, one of the most fundamental steps involved in manufacturing is the design of the plant or the design of the manufacturing process. Therefore, if things are set right at the design stage itself, that would result in the most efficient and effective way of organizing things. Just as, for example, a student who is being taught is generally told, please ensure that you learn things right the first time itself. Once you have learned something incorrectly in your early days, it becomes quite difficult then to overwrite that. So the same principle is being implemented in this product design phase of cost reduction, wherein we try to emphasize on the thought that if at all one is seriously concerned about cost reduction, please go and target the product design stage, because at the earliest stage, the starting stage, if you can tackle and arrive at some cost reduction, that will be long lasting. Just as we would typically say, even in Tamil, ஐந்தில் விளையாதது ஐம்பதில் விளையுமா. The same thing occurs even over here. Go and tap something which is at a very nascent stage of the manufacturing cycle to have a long-lasting effect. Now there, you might possibly look at cheaper substitutes. Please bear in mind, this cannot compromise quality, existing quality, or probably a higher yield, which results in lesser consumption of materials or results in lesser wastage. Reduce time, save the time of operation, conducting the activity, which will result in increased productivity or output, probably standardization and simplification, which can also help. Now, from the next aspect to be covered is organization. Now, this is something which is looked at from an administrative perspective. From a cost, if one wants to ensure cost reduction, it is very important that the support activities also happen properly. Something, for example, as I am saying over here, this refers to something which is support activity or tertiary activity. Now, one cannot say that only the primary activity should be investigated into, wherein wastages would be minimal, but then the support activities can probably overshoot their expenses. Shouldn't happen, because we are looking at the entire value chain. Now, when as a student you are studying, just imagine a student's condition if that student has to probably go earn her or his bread for the day, has to cook and eat. Where is the time to sit and study? Now, there are some people in the house, the father, the mother, taking care of those particular activities, freeing up a lot of time as well as stress for the child. And therefore, the child is able to utilize by investing the time entirely in his or her education. So the role that the father and the mother plays is not directly involved in the study. They don't study for the child. But then what they do, is probably something far more important than what the child actually does, because if the food is not served on a timely basis as a support activity, where is the energy in the body to sustain into the future? That's typically what happens even here. The organization structure must be something which is friendly, something which is really conducive. Now, there should be proper alignment of tasks in the organization, the kind of responsibility which has been delegated, the authority that stands delegated, responsibility that stands given must be okay, which means the organization structure should be okay. Channel of communication between various levels must be seamlessly existing. Friction should probably be avoided. Okay. People or employees must be encouraged to express their views. All these things also add a lot to the cost reduction program. Then the third significant aspect is the factory layout and the equipment. Now, from a cost reduction perspective, it's very important to understand the factory layout. If the layout is not going to be conducive, is not going to be appropriate, then definitely it is going to have a long-term effect in terms of incurring extra costs. You may not be able to avoid the wastages, maybe in terms of materials handling, etc., etc. For example, just imagine in a factory, the inventory storekeeping place is kept far away from the production line. Every time the production or the assembly line requires material, the materials will have to be transported within the factory from the storehouse to the production unit, which is going to involve a lot of materials handling and transportation. So there could be a transportation cost as well as a material handling related expenditure, probably also some damage that could occur in the process of transporting at this distance. This could probably be avoided by trying to see at the start itself, when the layout is being designed, whether the production unit or the assembly line can be placed as close as possible to the inventory storekeeping place, so that material handling expenditure, damage related expenditure, as well as your transportation expenses can be brought down significantly. So this is just an example to communicate to you that cost reduction can be thought about right at the start stage itself. Then comes a production plan, program and method, which is basically coming to the production unit in the assembly line where the operational activity is being carried out, where maybe you say material, men, other resources are being used. So every single, the equipments are being used, materials are being used, raw materials, manpower is being used. Every single thing that stands used in the production plant would obviously expose itself to the risk of being either underutilized or probably overutilized. Maybe labor is remaining idle. It could be normal, it could be abnormal. Normal idle time is okay, but then abnormal idle time is something which will have to be investigated as it results in a huge cost. Materials probably are being overstocked or probably are not being handled the way they should be. I mean, within the production plant itself, a material that has to be processed by one machine A and then by machine B has to be transported a long distance, involves a lot of material handling expenses. So could that probably be thought about? Can idle capacity be reduced? Such things are being thought about actually in this particular phase from a cost reduction perspective.